So what is cloaking? In order to remotely access a Raspberry Pi, SSH or VNC needs to be enabled. Enabling both of these services opens up ports over the local network. Cloaking binds these services to the local host IP address, so the Raspberry Pi is no longer visible to port scans on the local network or through port forwarding. No one can start a connection from the outside or even see the Raspberry Pi. It's as if it's not even there. Once cloaked, the only way to access the Raspberry Pi is to use remote.it. Before you begin, you will need to create a remote.it account at the remote.it website, enable SSH and VNC access on your Raspberry Pi, and register the Raspberry Pi on remote.it. To do this, you can either install remote.it from the command line of the Raspberry Pi, or if you have not set up your Raspberry Pi yet, you can use our remote.it Pi SD card image. If you need help with any of this, please see the information linked in the description box below. I will start by showing how an SSH and VNC-enabled Raspberry Pi can be found over the local network. As I said before, when you enable SSH and VNC access on your Raspberry Pi, you are opening those two ports over the local network. A port scanner can be used to find these open ports. In this case, I'm using a port scanner called Fing. I'm showing this step on an iPhone, but Fing is also available on Android. So I'll start by opening the app. You can see here that the phone is connected to a network called remote.it. If you click the Scan for Devices button, a list of all of the devices on the network will load. This is the Raspberry Pi. I know that its local IP address is 10.0.0.64. I'm going to tap on the Raspberry Pi, and I'll be brought to this screen. Then I'll scroll down and select this Find Open Ports button. As you can see, Fing has been able to find both the SSH and VNC services right away. Now to show that both of these services are viable, I'll use them to connect to my Raspberry Pi. Okay, now I'm on my Mac computer. This computer is connected to the same network as my Raspberry Pi and my mobile phone. I'll start by connecting via SSH. I'll open Terminal and input this command, SSH space dash L space Pi space, and then the local IP address of the Raspberry Pi. Then I'll be asked for the password of my Raspberry Pi, and now I'm in my Raspberry Pi's terminal and can use it as usual. This remote.it Pi is written here because this Raspberry Pi has already been set up with remote.it. But just to clarify, just now I did not use remote.it to access this Raspberry Pi. I only used the Pi's local IP address. Now I'll run an ls command just to show that the connection is working. And here you can see all the files on the Raspberry Pi. Okay, so now I'm going to exit out of that and connect using VNC. To do this, I'm going to use a VNC client application. In this case, I'm using RealVNC's VNC Viewer app. I've linked to it in the description box below. Then I will paste the local IP address of the Raspberry Pi here and press Enter. It will ask for the credentials of the Raspberry Pi. The default username for the Raspberry Pi is Pi. And now I'm in my Raspberry Pi's desktop interface and can use it as usual. So now that I've shown how an SSH and VNC-enabled Raspberry Pi can be found and accessed from another device on the LAN, I'll teach you how to cloak the Raspberry Pi so it'll no longer be visible over the local network and can no longer be accessed using its local IP address. In order to cloak a Raspberry Pi, you're going to need to upload cloaking scripts into your remote.it account. To get these scripts, go to the remote.it downloads page. Under Raspberry Pi, find the Raspberry Pi cloaking scripts. In this tutorial, I'll be downloading both the SSH and VNC cloaking scripts, but you can always download just one or the other, depending on which services you have enabled and which ones you would like to cloak. I'll start with the SSH script. Click on this button. You will be brought to this GitHub page. You can see the name of the script here. It's called Cloak SSH, and it's a shell script. Next, you're going to want to press this raw button, and the full script will appear. Now, if you're on a Mac, just press Command S to save the script. The script will automatically save as a shell script to your downloads folder. You can actually save it wherever you want, just as long as you remember where you saved it. Then press Save, and the script will download. Go back to the remote at download page, and you'll complete the same process for the VNC script. You will again be brought to a GitHub page. This time it's the page for the Cloak VNC script. Same as before, press this raw button, and the full script will appear. Press Command S to save the script, and press Save. And the script will download. Now that you have downloaded both of the scripts, go back to the remote.it website, and sign into your remote.it account. Once in the remote.it web portal, go to the scripting page, press the blue upload button, click choose file, and select one of the scripts you just downloaded. I'll start with the SSH script. Then click open. Under choose file type, select executable script or program. Then click upload. This orange box that says upload succeeded will appear. Now from the same window, you can go back and click choose file. This time, select the VNC script. And make sure the executable script or program is still selected. Then click upload. This orange box will reappear, indicating that the script has been uploaded. Now if you close this dialog and click the Scripts button, you will see both the SSH and VNC scripts in your remote account. You are now ready to cloak your Raspberry Pi. Next, I will show you how to cloak the Raspberry Pi using the cloaking scripts. From the remote web portal, go to the Devices page. In the device list, select the checkmark next to your Raspberry Pi. In this tutorial, I will only be cloaking one Raspberry Pi, but you can cloak multiple at once if you have more Raspberry Pis registered in your remote account. Go to this Actions drop-down menu and select Execute Script. This window will appear. Select the SSH script, then click Next. Then select Cloak Service and click Finish. Selecting this checkbox will allow you to see which devices have been cloaked while this action is being executed. In this case, only one Raspberry Pi is being cloaked, so it doesn't really matter if the box is checked or not. Then click Submit. In the status columns, you can see that an SSH service has been cloaked. Now to execute the VNC cloaking script, recheck the checkbox next to the Raspberry Pi and carry out the same steps. Select Execute Script, select the Cloak VNC script, then click Next. Then select Cloak Service, click Finish, and then Submit. If the status columns don't show that the VNC service has been cloaked, it's likely the script is still running. To check, just go to the Scripting tab. As you can see here, both the Cloak SSH and Cloak VNC scripts are still running. So just wait a few minutes, and when the scripts are done, a green checkmark will appear. So now if you try to use a port scanner to look for open ports on the Raspberry Pi, no open ports will be found. This is because the SSH and VNC services have been cloaked to only use the localhost. The services will no longer respond to network packets that originate from the phone or any other device on the network, making the Raspberry Pi essentially invisible over the local network. To confirm that this Raspberry Pi can no longer be accessed from another computer on the network, I'll try to connect using the same methods I used before cloaking the two services. If I open Terminal and enter the same command, the connection will be refused. Similarly, if I open the VNC client application, I can just press the Save to Local IP address to connect to it. The connection will be refused. Now the only way to connect to this cloaked Raspberry Pi over the local network is to use remote.it. So if you go back to the remote.it portal and click the Connect button next to the cloaked Raspberry Pi and select SSH, you'll be given an address that when you copy and paste into Terminal, will allow you to connect to the Raspberry Pi's terminal. Note that when you're using the remote.it web portal, you're making a proxy connection, so these addresses will expire. If you'd like to make a peer-to-peer connection, you can connect to the Raspberry Pi using the remote.it desktop application. More information about the differences between these two types of connections is available in the description box below. Okay, so paste the address remote.it provided here. You get this warning the first time you use this address. Just type yes. Then enter the password of the Raspberry Pi. And there you go, you're connected to your Raspberry Pi's command line. I'll type ls again just to show that it's connected, and here are all the files on the Raspberry Pi. So I'll exit out of that. To connect using VNC, go back to the remote.it web portal. Again, click on the connect button next to the Raspberry Pi, and select VNC instead. For the real VNC VNC Viewer app, you will need to use the bottom address, but if you're using a different VNC client application, make sure to choose the address that matches the specifications of the application. Then open the VNC client application. This time you won't be using the local IP address. Instead, paste the address given by remote.it. This warning appears the first time you connect to an address. Just press continue. Then enter the credentials of the Raspberry Pi. And there you go, you're back into the desktop interface of your cloaked Raspberry Pi. Just as a note, when you're using your remote.it, you don't need to be on the local network to access the Raspberry Pi. You will also be able to access the Raspberry Pi remotely from a different network. You can also uncloak the Raspberry Pi by a procedure very similar to how you cloaked it. From the remote.it web portal, select the Raspberry Pi and go to the Actions menu. Select Execute Script. I'll start by uncloaking the SSH script. Then click Next. The only difference is that at this screen, select the Uncloak Service option. Then click Finish and Submit. Under the status columns, you'll see that the SSH service has been uncloaked. The same process can be used for the VNC script. Select the Raspberry Pi and go to the Actions menu. Select Execute Script, and then select the VNC script, and click Next. Select the Uncloak Service option, then click Finish, and Submit. Again, under the status columns, you'll see that the VNC service has been uncloaked. Now if you go back to the port scanner and rescan the Raspberry Pi, the SSH and VNC service will reappear because they are both no longer cloaked. You are now once again able to use the local IP address of the Raspberry Pi, or you could still use remote.it to connect. Just a reminder, you are only able to use the local IP address when you are remotely connecting from a device that's on the same network as the Raspberry Pi. If you're on a different network, regardless if you've cloaked your Raspberry Pi, you will need to use remote.it to connect to it. Just to further show that this Raspberry Pi has been uncloaked and can once again be accessed using its local IP address, I'll go back to the Mac computer, open Terminal, enter the same command I used before I cloaked the Raspberry Pi, then I'll enter the password of the Pi, and now I'm back in my Raspberry Pi's command line. Now I'll exit out and connect using VNC. To connect to my local IP address, I can just click on this box, since I've already connected with it before. Then I'll enter the password of the Raspberry Pi. And once again, I have access to the Raspberry Pi's desktop interface. For additional information, check out our website or contact support@remote.it. Thanks for watching.